¿Qué pasa, familia? Son las Navidades, así que vamos a beber, vamos a celebrar, pero vamos a tomarnos algo de los cubanos. Vamos a crear cócteles y memorias aquí en Liquid Memoir. Welcome back, everyone, to another cocktail episode at Liquid Memoir. I'm Gabriel Morales. There's a large YouTube community of cocktail enthusiasts and bartenders. And two of my friends, Rob's from Rob's Home Bar and Vino Valentino from 60 Second Cocktail, they joined up and created a Christmas Martini 2020 challenge. Great thing about this is that anybody can join in. There's just a couple simple rules. Número uno, create a cocktail in a martini glass. Número dos, upload the video or Instagram post of said cocktail with the hashtag ChristmasMartini2020. Today we're gonna be looking at my submission, El Presidente. When you wanna talk cocktail history, you cannot ignore Cuba. Cuba has been serving cocktails since 1859. And the cocktail that we're making today, El Presidente, it was discovered in a book called El Manual del Cantinero, published in 1915. It was also reported that this drink was immensely popular amongst Cubans between 1920s and 1940s. There's a lot more cocktail history within Cuba, but we're not gonna get into all that. But what we're gonna get into is making this cocktail, but with a slight personal twist to it. Before we make the drink, we're gonna need some grenadine. I highly recommend you make your own. I'm gonna make a very easy pomegranate syrup. Start by combining half a cup or 150 grams of each unfiltered, unsweetened pomegranate juice and granulated sugar. Bring it to medium heat and stir constantly until the sugar is completely dissolved. Once the sugar is completely, and I mean completely dissolved, set aside and let it cool to room temperature. Then bottle, label, and refrigerate. Keeps for 2 weeks. Now we can make the drink. Reminder, this is not the classic Cuban Presidente. Start by adding 2 dashes of chocolate mole bitters. These bitters will add a nice spice and holiday cheers to the cocktail that will blend very nicely with our syrup. Then add 1 teaspoon or 5 mils of your house-made pomegranate syrup. As for orange liqueur, I'm gonna use Pierfarant Dry Curaçao. It will combine very nicely with our previous ingredients without adding too much sweetness. As for the vermouths, we're gonna do something a bit different from the classic. I'm gonna use both dry and blanc vermouths. Dry vermouths tend to be, well, dry, with hints of bitter citrus, genepi, and a slightly salty mouthfeel. Blanc vermouth, on the other hand, is a nice middle ground between dry vermouths and sweet vermouths. Doesn't add much bitterness, but still adds some nice floral flavors and just enough fruit and sweetness. Pour 3/4 ounce or 22.5 mils of both dry and blanc vermouths. As for our rums, first I'm gonna add a little bit of body to this cocktail by using 1/2 ounce or 15 mils of Hamilton Pot Still Black. Finally, add 1 whole ounce or 30 mils of aged Puerto Rican rum. If you happen to have aged Cuban rum, go for it. Add your ice and give it a good stir, about 15 seconds. Once done, strain your cocktail into a chilled martini glass. And for the garnish, squeeze the zesty oils of an orange peel. You may drop it in the glass, but to that, I'm gonna add a house-made brandy cherry. You can find the recipe for these cherries in the link below. And that's El Presidente. Cheers.
We have El Presidente. This is delicious. It's really good. It's really good. You get the orange, the pomegranate, the 2 different rums, that spicy chocolate mole bitters. Absolutely fantastic. All those ingredients really work well together. Obviously, this is not going to be your traditional El Presidente. I wanted to take that Cuban flair and combine it with my style of drinking and making drinks.
And I think this came out really good. I'm really happy how this came out. Spice things up a little bit on this holiday season. And hey, if you're into it, light up a cigar while you have this drink. Thank you so much, everyone, for watching. If you haven't already, please like and subscribe. Also, check out the Christmas Martini 2020 hashtag. It's going to be right above the title of this video. If you click on that hashtag, you're going to see all the drink submissions for all the Christmas Martini 2020 challenge. Big shout out for my buddies, Rob and Vino, for coming together and just bringing together all this amazing YouTube talent that's out there for all these bartenders and cocktail enthusiasts. And yeah, guys, I want to wish you all a happy holiday. Stay safe, drink responsibly. I'll see you guys in the next one. Salud.